not on the Passion of the Christ. I love this director. I love this film. No, I'm just trying to be funny. Because yes, I love this director. About loving this film, I don't know. I'm just overwhelmed. I'm still thinking about the great Bacall Jurmakovic, and he has this line that he repeats in towns as a magician. I love this town, and I don't know why he's talking in my head about this. Well, a very disputed film. I, for one, don't feel so much the controversy because, first of all, I'm not really religious. I just, but still trying to find. And so I'm not looking with that lens, if you will. How can he show Jesus and a large part of the public that is very, very sensitive to this? After all, Jesus, Termina, figures around Mary Magdalene, the mother of Christ, are sacred figures that you cannot. You cannot be too careful. I mean, you have to portray them as saintly, as and it's beyond human powers to do that, supposedly, if you go with this argument. But as I said, I keep seeing Mel Gibson in various films. Here he's not present, of course, but he's the director. And I cannot help but observe that he was really very good. It's a pity that as a man he showed a lamentable side. Granted, he was drunk, but then it's terrible. But one way maybe to look at this is that he had this talent. He was so gifted. He has he had all this work from Payback to The Year of Living Dangerously, from Mad Max to the films he directed and played in Braveheart, acclaimed. Won so many prizes, Academy Award. And so all this might have had an impact, and there you go. They say it's difficult to be an artist at one point. So anyway, we're talking here about the last 12 hours of Jesus. Jim Caviezel, very good in this. There's the beautiful Monica Bellucci and our very own Maya Morgenstern. I'm laughing a little because I think I've also read somewhere that those who come in contact with this subject, very delicate and very religious and divine and sensitive and all that I've said, sometimes have trouble recuperating. I'm now thinking, Aldous Huxley, Point and Counterpoint, the novel wherein there is an actress who plays a role, but she becomes the role. And then there's another line in a film I've seen recently, and I don't think I remember where, but when an actor becomes, maybe it's Trumbo, Bryan Cranston, when an actor becomes the role, what do? You fire him. So my mother's staying at home, but she's acting strange in her real life. And then specifically on this film, our most brilliant mind, Andrei Pleșu, had an article in which he was not happy with what happened in there, and if I remember well, he criticized his the work of the aforementioned actress, who is really, if you ask me, is really bizarre in her appearances lately. Maybe it's on account of portraying somebody sentient, she has attracted the wrath of God. I don't know, as I said, I'm not really a believer, so I don't know.